My name is Jude McKendrick, and I make this open statement for the attention of David Cameron, Prime Minister of the United Kingdoms. I make this statement as a result of his public declaration to make MPs and government representatives answerable to their constituents and citizens of the United Kingdoms, of which I am one. This statement is also made as a result of repeated attempts to ascertain that my human rights be upheld as a member of the human race. A member of the human race whose rights have been blatantly and repeatedly abused since around March of 2007. It's my belief that these abuses have been happening with the knowledge of members of the British government and its various departments belonging to divisions of local authority responsibility. Staff members of the Department of Works and Pensions and therefore representatives of national and local government, the local council, and various other local authority departments, all who work under the umbrella of local authority and government sectors and are therefore representatives of government departments with a duty of care towards me and others like me who pay taxes which contribute to their wages. These abuses began around February, March 2007 when I was wrongfully accused by local housing benefits officers on behalf and in collision with Telford and Wrekin Housing Trust of fraud, allegations which were dropped, although the ongoing harassment and extortion of finances by them on me continued until 2010. I have documented evidence of this to support these allegations on both counts. Resulting from these errors, my health and well-being have been negatively affected by financial and emotional stress, with serious negative impact on financial, social, physical and emotional well-being. Again, I have medical evidence, psychological and financial evidence to support these allegations. I make this statement, Mr. Cameron, as a direct attempt to draw your attention to these abuses of my human and civil rights, since all previous attempts by me to contact you have been ignored. As a result, I believe this to either be a reflection of incompetence by your staff to bring these communications regarding these abuses to your attention, or a further attempt by you personally to cause further negative impact on my health and well-being. Mr. Cameron, I have written to you by email on several occasions in regard of the abuses I have been subjected to, and it's my belief that you are well aware of them. If you are not, then I suggest there are serious flaws within your administration, because not only have I written to you by email with detailed accounts of the abuses of my human and civil rights, I have also emailed your Deputy Prime Minister, the Omnibus Man, and the European Court of Human Rights, and also given copies of these documents to my local Tory MP, Mark Pritchard, with a request to deliver them to you personally and have issues in these documents addressed by Parliament. I have also made some copies of these documents and communications public through Facebook and Twitter, as well as contacting several press and media outlets and even some celebrities. And yes, Prime Minister, again, I have documented evidence to prove these communications were made. Frankly, if you're not aware of the content of them and the issues involved, then not only are your personal administrative team failing you, but I suggest your intelligence department is sorely failing and not quite up to scratch. Although personally, I think it's more likely that a gagging order has been applied to me in regard of press and media communications. I think it is also prevalent to point out for the record, Mr. Cameron, that not only do I have detailed documentation to support these allegations, but I also believe in regard of the many issues involved in these abuses of my rights, I think I have unquestionable proof of these abuses and failures of public bodies and government departments to address and rectify these issues appropriately, again causing further negative impact on my well-being as a result. Furthermore, Mr. Cameron, I have supporting medical evidence which verifies that I am neither insane or delusional, and that if I am suffering from mental health issues, they are directly as a result of stress resulting from the abuses by the aforementioned government departments, representative bodies of local and national authority. You should also be aware, Mr. Cameron, that I am an educated woman with a university level education in social care and welfare, who as a result of the ongoing abuses by your regime and under the previous Prime Minister, who also received emails in regard of the issues involved, gave up her education at BA level studying European social policy, and as a result of both the stresses these abuses caused and my studies during these abuses, I know my rights, both human and civil, because I have researched and studied these areas of social care, policy and practice, and I have researched legislation in regard to the treatment I have received, studying in particular British legislation and acts of law, justice and rights. I am outraged by the behaviours I have been subjected to, Mr. Cameron, and I hold you and your government responsible for the continuing infringements of my rights and me being abused. And in particular, I find it reprehensible in reflection of ignorance and bad manners, let alone the business practice of your representatives and you to address these issues, or even have the basic good manners to reply to my correspondence, in particular with regard to my repeated requests and communications with Mark Pritchard, Conservative MP for Telford and Wrekin, the constituency where I live, and for his failures to respond to my requests for appointments since giving him the paperwork to deliver to you for response. I understand, Mr. Cameron, that you may think that if you ignore me or were able to use various local and national government departments to apply enough pressure, I might crack up and give up my endeavours to seek justice. Or maybe you were of the belief that if you implemented some tactical, strategic measures to defamate my character or use bullying and terrorising tactics on me, I might be, as a result of the pressure, pushed over the edge enough to top myself. Let me assure you, Mr. Prime Minister, this little lady won't be bullied. Been there, done that, and not scared no more of any big boys, big girls, out to earn themselves PowerPoints, praise or popularity. Therefore, Mr. Cameron, I would be obliged if you could contact your administrative team and get them to check through your emails for those I have sent you, to check out the posts I have made regarding these issues, failing that, get some intelligence together and check out Twitter or Facebook, or even ask Mark Pritchard what the fuck he's playing at if he failed to deliver the documents to you that I gave to him with a request to deliver them personally for your attention and response. Because I can assure you, Mr. Prime Minister, my human and civil rights have been abused, and these abuses have been perpetuated on your watch as Chief Executive and Managing Director of Team UK. You have failed me in your duty of care. Furthermore, I am not only entitled to be heard and have the right to a fair trial and justice, you have made it a matter of public notice by your own statements that you will make MPs and representatives of government answerable to people like me. But you, Mr. Cameron, have also stated that you will fire those who fail to do their job to a proper and expected high standard. In conclusion, Mr. Cameron, I shall now await your response. If I do not get the answers I am entitled to, I shall presume that you are not up to the job. A post you took without common consensus of the people, resulting from a hung parliament, when the people, by their votes, made it clear to all political parties that they had little confidence in any of them or their manifesto promises. I shall continue with my endeavours to find justice through the legal system in the United Kingdom and also start proceedings on humanitarian grounds through the European Court of Human Rights against you and your representatives, not only for the abuses I have been subjected to, but to raise awareness of these issues and the impact they have on those like me, as I believe I have a duty of care to other members of the human race, just like me, who suffer the effects of poor managerial skills, poor business conduct, malpractice, negligence and conspiracy to divert the course of justice, as I believe I have been subjected to by you and your predecessors' governments. As I have already stated, I have more than enough documented evidence not only to support my claims but to prove beyond a shadow of a doubt that your government, both at local and national level, have abused my rights. And as you have stated repeatedly, I am entitled to answers from you and your employees and representatives. And finally, Mr. Cameron, the next time you prepare your speech for the House of Commons, making declarations of what type of action or punishment should befall autocratic tyrants and leaders waging war and committing abuses and genocide against their own people, may I suggest you pause to reflect that these same men you condemn took power without the consent of the people and laid out dictates on political reform, education and health, employment and economics, policies, procedures that they implemented without public support, that saw the masses go jobless, homeless and penniless and in despair. Policies and procedures they quickly pushed through into law with negative impacts on the health and social well-being and human rights of their people, which in retrospect give a fair example as to the possible and very probable effects and effects of your coalition austerity measures on UK citizens. And like your own and predecessors' governments, much of these decisions and meetings about how they would finance and implement these rules of law they made behind closed doors, and many of these decisions made behind these closed doors were supported and financed by you and your predecessors' governing bodies while brokering business deals. You have spoke of transparency, Mr. Cameron, and its importance in government, and yet on your watch, I have been made feel invisible, non-existent and insignificant as a human being. So, while I wait to hear from you, Mr. Cameron, I shall further reflect on how I see you and the responses to these matters I have tried very hard to rectify since the issues began, and how I shall see this through without becoming what some may consider just another collaterally damaged statistic. Or maybe you, Mr. Cameron, should contemplate how people see you, or even may come to see through you and your big autocratic society agenda.